High Chieftain Grex told us that the source of the evil mist that has been messing with this entire island is in the cave to the northeast right here, but we're gonna finish every other quest we have first. Or at least one other quest we have first. I was poking around between this video and the last one, and I found the for Ebbeck's missing parts, the triangle spinner is right here. So we'll just pick that up right there. And now we have to do the very important tasks of greeting a musician and greeting Dirk and Gonko right here, but they're busy defending their home for a moment, so I'll just let them do that and not help at all. Come on, guys. Good job. Okay, I'll help with this one. I don't want to wait again. Oh, and they're not even going to help me. Okay, well, we did that very fast. Oh. Come on, guys. Give me a chance to talk to you. At least in my mind, I feel like you can't talk to them if they're in combat. Dirk, happy to meet you. Gonk, not bonk, diplomat. Thank you. Here comes another ambusher for them to kill. There they go. And I think most of what we need is right over here. Also, I haven't mentioned, if you've noticed, these natural gardens and just stuff like that, and these glowing things on the ground, these are just collectibles. Not tied to any quest, just achievements, basically, so I don't really care too much about them, to be honest. Sapswell Villager. Passed out Sapswell. There's a musician. Here's an... this is probably an active Sapswell. Oh, very happy one. Here's an active one. Alright, now we get to pay respect to High Chieftain Grex. Oh, Ghosts and Goblins, I must get water from the Hope's Falls waterfall. Is that this one, or it might be the one on the other side? Okay, it's the one on the other side. You got it. Oh, no, I need... Okay, there's a lot of objectives to that quest. So this other waterfall is probably also required, and man, for a frog, I am moving, or swimming, very slowly. Come on, buddy. Oh, shucks. I was hoping the rest of the water would be as shallow. There's that. Okay. Also, gather roots. I know where those are. I think the roots are near, I think they're all over the place, but I know for a fact that there's some near the musician in that group of goblins that we just talked to. And here, yeah, here they are. They're very difficult to miss. There's two roots, but I guess it only counts for one in our quest. Did that not work? Nothing found, that's why. So I guess we just need, the quest would more accurately say three successful harvesting from roots. There's 10, but once again only counted for one. And we got a rare item, Yarrow, wow. Or Yarrow, maybe, I'm not sure. Okay, now we just need the Razortooth Falls waterfall, which I want to say is right over here. Towards the edge of the area, but since we're closer to Grex, let's do that. Cave of Fog to northeast here must go. I'm just paying my respects to your Grexness, which is interesting that that quest dialogue changes depending on whether or not you've accepted the Source of Evil quest or not. Okay, tune that to us and equip it, and we are good to go. And that... there was a tree. Oh, yep, right there. That tree glitches out at this distance. Probably has something to do with my settings. So once again, we are going to go far away from the objective and go to this bridge over here. I'm really glad these enemies don't aggro. And here's the last piece we need that was overlooking the bay. The size 7 clunker. And we are done. Now I'm trying to get water from the Razortooth Falls waterfall without actually falling. There we go. Whew, close call. I think the intention is for you to fall down there and then have to swim all the way back up, but if you nudge it just a little bit, you're able to get the water without worrying about it. I think we have to turn in both of these quests. Oh no, Epic and then the Goblin, of course. Grex promises us and his promises is kept. I've gotten the items you ask for. Yes, yes, freshest waters, tasty roots. Now will I tell you what you want to know? What do you want to know? The forest keeper said you know how to stop the corruption of the colony. Me, no. Grex knows all. No sayings need to soothe on that. Ha, huh? Why'd she tell you such a joke? Ha, evil things creeping up on poor Gobby's long time now. Big tree is wrong. Nothing new to know about that. Happy you came to help us, though. Then what was all that stuff for? Ah, tasty roots. Mash them up, grind them up, and soak in the waters. After the moons are new again, ready to drink it is. Helps to forget, helps to remember. Tasty roots. You mean you're going to make a brew out of them? Yes, yes, tasty brew. If you knew there was no sooth to be said, would you have got tasty roots and fresh waters for us? No. So now we have them, and now you will know as much as Saps wills. Even trade, share with you, we will too. I don't think it's very even. Greetings, happy friend, and we got the Sapswell hip sack, excuse me, which has 5 slots, so we can act, and we got some of the Sapswell swill, which increases our power regen of, for 15, or by 15, that lasts for 30 minutes. So because that hip pouch has more slots than any of our other bags, let's go ahead and equip it. Now, if we open them up, we should have, look at that, 1 extra slot. Just fantastic. Very, very good. Alright, and Epic is all the way down there, so now we can just continue the main storyline and follow our noses to the fog. And then enter this cave, a dark doorway. Fog emanates from the cracks in this door. And we load into the source of evil. Game freezes. Okay. And we are greeted to a tainted Sapswell warrior, 2 warriors and a hunter, and then Vith Latar. And these people are an encounter, so let's start with our encounter attack. And it should do a decent amount of damage, yeah. Phenobin will probably finish them off quicker than we can, but. Why don't you say hello to some old friends? Your blood calls to me. Our loyalty points tokens have increased. I don't really know what that means, so you'll notice that we can't attack Vith Latar or her minions here, but we can interact with these totems. So all we need to do is destroy them, and they say, no, not the totems, how did you know? And you say, well, Vith Latar, I knew because of the previous quest. That's how we are foiling your evil plan here. Quite a nuisance you are. My patience is gone. Prepare for my wrath. Well, unfortunately, Vith Latar is only level 6. So I'm just waiting for her to aggro now. Oh, she... a bunch of bats. And... oh, well. Okay. I did literally nothing in that encounter. That was all Phenobin. She dropped the symbol of Vith, which is another stat. Oh, it's a wand, actually. We can equip that. And also, nice, a spell upgrade for our Earthen Avatar. Also, I could have sworn that I turned Steam notifications off. Sorry about that. Okay, let's go ahead and upgrade that. And now, okay. And I think we have to desummon and resummon him because of that. And now he'll come back just a little bit stronger because we are adept ranking in Earthen Avatar now. So let's get back to High Chieftain Grex now. For lack of a better word, that was kind of the final boss of the tutorial island, which does make sense because it was the first time we were really needed to do mechanics in order to defeat her. And this is not a very mechanic-heavy game, at least not from a casual perspective. Probably a rating perspective. I'm gonna go ahead and turn those off really quick. Okay. Sorry about those blurred Steam notifications coming up in the bottom right. Let's see Grex reward. us. Ah, truth, the prophecy speaks. The great balancing is complete. Okay, sorry, I got distracted because with the loyalty tokens, I have no idea what those mean. When you get one, there's a really obnoxious, loud horn blasting kind of musical cue. Truth, the prophecy speaks. The great balancing is complete. Evil, our hero has conquered. The saps will shall always remember and rebuild. We will in your name. Take the hero's gift. I'm just paying my respects, Grexness. And he gave us the bone-plated gauntlets, which we can't use. So thanks a lot, High Chieftain. Really appreciate saving your whole town here. And now, coming back full circle, we have to return to Murar Shar and give Epic all the items he collected. We collected. I guess he, if I'm talking about my character. See a little teeny tiny red book right here as we swim back. Let's take advantage of our water breathing. Actually, I can show off something else pretty neat. If I can remember how to open up my skills, there we go. Froglocks also have access to, I think it's on the next page, Aqua Vision. So you'll see if you go into the water by default, it's kind of blurry and you can't really see that clearly, but because we are a water-dwelling race, we can cast Aquavision, and it makes things just a little teeny-tiny bit more clear. That's the only unique thing we have to start. I think the cat people or lion race, what Murar Shar is, the Kara, I believe they start with night vision, which I believe just kind of applies a filter to the screen, but from a lore perspective, it's pretty cool. Lets you see a little bit brighter at night. Here you go, Mr. Wobblegog. Yes, 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 these are all the parts I need. Thank you ever so much. Please take this as a token of my appreciation. I'm sure the boat will be here any minute now. Good luck. And we now have new wrist armor. Oh, the lighting was making our sleeves look a lot cooler. I thought we had armor shoulder pads or something, but it was just the lighting. Much to my disappointment. Alrighty, Murar Shar. By the glory of Qeynos, whatever. I'll just alternate, it doesn't even matter. By the glory of Qeynos, you've done it. The source of evil is gone and the island is saved. You are on a path to greatness. Your deeds here shall not be forgotten, and I foresee many more adventures ahead of you. It was nothing, really. Nothing. I will tell the queen personally of your bravery. Take this reward as a gift from Qeynos. Feel free to head to Qeynos at any time, or stay and hone your skills. Speak with Captain Varlos on the docks when you wish to leave. Thanks. Okay, and just to recap real quick, I was able to help Sorcerer Ufala and destroy the totems that had spread the evil into the village. Removing the totems brought forth an evil champion that I took care of as well. The Dark Blade Master had... Why is it talking about the Dark... Oh, it's just a huge recap of a lot of the quests. Alright, that's fine. So I won't read the whole thing. Except, and let's equip those. We got a nice dagger, which will probably look, a decent amount cooler than the one we had before. And then the commemorative Qeynos coin. I think this plays voice acting. Yeah, it just says as you examine the coin, a magical voice fills your mind. But this is just the Queen Antonia Bale, the person he was talking about. And she just does a really long voice acted clip with no subtitles about Qeynos and telling you why they're so great and why you should go there. Which you don't really have much choice if you're a good guy, but I am so close to level 10 that I really just want to go find something to kill. Although I'm kind of at the very beginning of this area now. Let's go see if we can find anything. I just realized how sad when we got upgraded to Adept Earthen Avatar, it changed the summon's name to Gabarab instead of Phenobin. Well, no, you know what? I'm just going to choose to believe that Phenomen has evolved into Gabarab, and he's still essentially the same person, because that's very sad if it gave me a whole new Earth and avatar. Because then it just begs the question, what happened to Phenomen, you know? So no, it's an evolution. That's going to take me a little bit to get to enemies that aren't gray. I'm pretty sure gray enemies. Because when enemies turn gray, they don't aggro onto you anymore, and I'm pretty sure they also stop yielding any experience to you. So how close are we? We are at 3,320 out of 3,400. That is so painfully close. Wish I had a speed boost of some kind. Oh, interesting. See, invisibility and all the other stuff we have casted are permanent buffs, but Aquavision only lasts for 2 hours. I wonder why that is. Maybe a holdover from a previous system, or maybe just a strange little technical idiosyncrasy with how the vision spells work, because I would not be surprised if the other, like night vision spells work exactly the same, and they also have 2 hours. You know what I'm thinking? Maybe we've officially not... Maybe we're officially not able to fight anything. Maybe everything's gray now that we're level 9. Oh, here we go. Fallen Assassin. We'll save these two goblins, Gonk and Dirk, some effort here. Well, that was very loud. And now we're level 10 and we got the spell Animated Dagger, which inflicts 40 to 60 piercing damage on target. That seems very, very good. What is that? What's the cooldown on that? 30 seconds, yeah. Also, Flash Cast and Vampire Bats. I'm pretty sure Vampire Bats is a dot. Yeah, 10 to 16 piercing damage. Yeah, we get a lot at level 10. Also, Shrink Servant. Shrinks target by 35%. Okay, so here's Gabarab. Let's see how much this shrinks them by. That's definitely effective, but what a weird percentage, 35. I wonder why, unless, I guess if you find these two, them two visually distracting or something, I'm not sure. What is Flash Cast? Your next primary pet summon will cast instantly and have no recovery time. The second pet summon will have a base cast time of 4 seconds. After a second pet is summoned, the spell will terminate. The spell can cast while using other abilities. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. I looked at the spell list for Conjurer, and I'm pretty sure I don't get another... Actually, let's make our dots. Those, okay. Oh, whoops, no, that's exactly what I wanted to do. I'm pretty sure that Conjurer doesn't get another pet until level 20, or maybe it's the mid-20s, I'm not even sure. So, actually, I want to test that out just for fun. Very nice, very satisfying. Okay, well, I was not expecting to be done with this so quickly. We don't have any more quests left, and we are only about 19 minutes in, so why don't we go ahead and get on the boat and look around Qeynos for a little bit? That should be fun. I definitely was not expecting to show anything other than the tutorial, but we have so much time. So, you ready to go ashore, matey? I can take ye all the way to Qeynos, or just as far as the Frostfang Sea. I think the Frostfang Sea is New Hallas, the tutorial zone that replaced this one for good characters, and Kelethan is another good starting zone, but I hate that area. It's actually the home area of the Fae race, so no, we're gonna go to Qeynos. You best be sure to explore the whole island before you leave. Norrath can be a dangerous place, you know. I'm ready for the challenges ahead. Take me to Qeynos. Yar, that's what we be needing. Okay then, off to Qeynos. Thanks for the ride. Don't you mind that, we get paid to do that. To Qeynos. And if I'm remembering correctly, I see that we got a new change popping up to accept when we load in. Or a new quest. It's called the Winds of Change, that's why I said that. There is a change on... Oh, that is a player on a gigantic dinosaur. And that's... Honestly, that's one of the things I love about playing these older MMOs that people have been playing for so long, so many years. They always have the most ridiculous, flashy stuff. There is a change unlike any before seen in the city of Qeynos. Not everyone embraces the change, and many seek... Excuse me. To destroy what they don't understand. The protection of its citizens is the kingdom's primary focus. It is for this reason that the order to relocate all within the safety of the city walls was decreed. I should visit the Lion's Mane Inn and Tavern in South Qeynos to see the new rooms for myself. Oh, is it just a housing quest? I think so. Well, we're not... I'm not interested in doing any more quests. I just want to walk around Qeynos. This is the Harbor District. A lot of people talking, a lot of NPCs to make the world feel more alive. The one thing I appreciate is in EverQuest 2 is how many explorable buildings there are in the cities. And there's a ton of these quests to accept, and just so many people to talk to, just to get an idea of what's going on in Qeynos. Listen here, this ain't no public brawl. The mermaid's lures for marauders only. I'm sorry I took a wrong turn. Farewell. Chances are, if you see something in this game, in a city, that you can't interact with or can't do anything with, or if an NPC like that guy just told me to get out of here, there is, I would say most of the time, probably a quest that pertains to that. And there's the really big palace. Some more players, too. So there are the... It is not one big seamless city, despite it looking like it on the map. You have to go between different sections, but actually in an update quite a few years ago, they did combine a lot of the areas that were previously between loading screens, which is a pretty neat thing for them to do. This is to the Gray Stone Yard. What does the entrance guard say? There's a whole lot of brawling in there. Best not to enter if you don't want to get hurt, but can we? No, we can't, okay. So I'm actually going to move through the city with the goal of showing you Antonica, which is the area right outside the main capital of Qeynos, and it is absolutely one of my favorite zones in any MMO, period. The palace is very cool. I'm not sure if we can go inside the palace. There's probably a prerequisite quest that we need to do. But dang it, we're going to try. This tunnel leads to a forest area, which is also nostalgic for me, but I'm not trying to get there. This leads to the down below, the grounds of the Fae. Oh, Qeynos Cat, I can just go over here. Okay, I was afraid I would have to go all the way through the dock. I thought I took a wrong turn. Although it doesn't really look like I'm able to go around this building. Maybe I can go through it. Sir Aiden Goddard, before you stands the Hall of Steel. Within these walls is the birthplace of the Steel Warriors, the greatest fighters in all of Nora. Thanks for the information, bub. Not looking very optimistic to get over there. Unless this opens up. No, it doesn't. That's tragic. Okay, we gotta go all the way around. I guess we'll try the other side of the building first, but I doubt it. It does not look like it on the map. Nope. Okay, we gotta go back through the harbor. That's fine. Just a lowly level 10 going through this very, very old city in this very, very old MMO. And looked very cool. The music is actually pretty nice. I want to say I remember an interview with the composer of the original game, or one of the composers of the original game, talking about just how much music they needed to make for this game, because SOE, the developer, really, really wanted unique music for each zone. And keep in mind that this was not the norm at the time that it came out, when MMOs were still so early on. Okay, now we're loading into the Qeynos Capital District. Obviously a zone getting its own theme nowadays is kind of par for the course, but back then it was not as common. Oh, I wanted to talk about alternate advancement points, and while we walk through this area, we can see if I can find out about those. Where are they? Alternate advancements, okay. So this is where the customization of this game really gets out of hand. We can choose one of these right now. So let's go focus on... Let's do focus fiery annihilation, which will give us a bunch of passive boosts and also increase this spell for us, but the game has so many skill trees and so much customization. All of these are choices that you can make and different trees you can go down. Now, the game does have server-side recommendations for solo, group, and PvP play, but you absolutely, and it automatically gives you a leveling, a solo leveling one, but you absolutely do not have to follow these if you don't want to, and I really like this level of customization. All of these trees grant you unique skills and everything, too, and unique titles, which is way much more important to me. I am a huge sucker for titles in this game, or in MMOs, period. There was something else I wanted to say about them. Oh, that's right. Unfortunately, it's something that took a really nasty hit during this game's conversion to free-to-play from subscription, but you used to be able to choose alternate advancement experiences earned alongside normal experience, level-up experience. But you used to be able to choose how much of the experience you earned you wanted to go to alternate advancement for the skill trees or your actual character level. And if you're free to play, you can still do that if you subscribe to the game, but if you're free to play, it's constantly split at 50% to level, 50% to alternate advancement, which is unfortunate in my opinion because it's such a unique mechanic, and I hate for that to be taken away for free to play players, but what can you do? Free to play is a rough transition, and here we are in Antonica, and we're running out of time, but opening on the map, you will see that we're right here. And just to give you a gauge of how big this area is, this is the distance we travel, and this is how big the zone is. And once again, my UI mod is really not doing justice for these. Unfortunately, not doing justice for these simple but very cool to look at maps. This is why there's not by default a ton of crap all over the screen. It's just to make quests easier, but this is Antonica. And it's just so wide and so open, and I've mentioned in videos before how much I love developers that are willing to give areas empty space, and I honestly don't like areas that are cluttered with crap to see everywhere. But since we're coming up on the end of the video here, I want to go over here. There's a big lighthouse there, but I want to talk to a Griffin Master over here. I think they might be called that, might be called something else, which can fly us to a different tower in Antonica, and I want to show, so I can show off the area from a better perspective. Griffin Tamer. I would like to travel to the Oracle, or this. Let's travel to the Step Station, which is actually called such because it links to the next area, which I'm not sure what level range it is, but it's definitely higher than where we are at 10, so here we go. Just have so much nostalgia and so many memories of flying through this entire area, or not flying through the area, walking through this entire area, finding quests, just sort of exploring and trying to figure out how to advance my character, which is interesting because honestly, in MMOs these days, I really just don't have the patience for that a lot of the time. Sometimes I do, but if an MMO is really obtuse about me finding out how to find quests in order to level up, it just sort of feels off to me, but weirdly enough, it's kind of hypocritical. It's something that I really appreciate about EverQuest 2. You know, we're really going far. Like, I remember we passed it a while back, but there was a wooden tavern, and you could go inside there, and there were a bunch of NPCs with quests to do. Is this the step? Is that it up there? No, that's just a destroyed tower and stuff like that. You see a destroyed tower in the distance, you want to go explore and see if there's anything to find there. As well as just the occasional buildings, the farmland, it's great. There's Lucklin up there. This is nice. I'm really glad, actually, that we finished the tutorial with so much time left, so I got to poke around Qeynos, but mostly show you Antonica. It's just such... I know it's probably not that impressive if you haven't seen it before and don't have nostalgia for stuff like this, but I just absolutely love it. Because it's open and spread out, but also very visually distinct. And yeah, the game tells you this is a landing zone. Please leave the platform, as if there's any negative to staying there. The thundering steps, that's why it's called the step station. I was hoping there would be a few enemies around just so I could see what level range I'm not supposed to be at. But, okay, we're over 30 minutes, but I want to check out this building too. I could poke around in this area for hours, and I have logged on to my level 90 and just walked around Antonica. Oh, level 15, okay, that enemy would be bad news if I got near it. And a feral timber wolf. Well, luckily we can just dive into the moat around the keep of the Knoll Slayers. Right, I want to see if these NPCs will actually talk about being Knoll Slayers. You look right strong, care to do for a job for the guard. Okay, so this guy probably would have a quest if we were appropriate level. We have so many adventures out these days that I think the Knolls decided to push back a bit. We heard they're plotting inside Blackburrow. I think you could also help us out. No thanks. I think Blackburrow is a open world dungeon, actually, where you can do a bunch of quests. And here's Sir Hegel Hammerheart. He trusts our travels are going well. Our travels are definitely going well. Oh, this guy, I remember this guy, actually. He has very shiny armor, which I believe is actually the... If you're a paladin, you get a specific quest line to get this armor, and it's so shiny and obnoxious, it's fantastic. And Captain Beltho, look at this guy. Okay. Enough wasting time. I was hoping we could get to the top of the building, but it doesn't look like we can, so I am just going to turn my camera around here. And, well, I won't stop looking at Gabarath, but I will still wave. Do a little hat tip to you and say goodbye to EverQuest 2 and Antonica in this video anyway, or in these videos. Thank you so much for watching me bumble through the tutorial of EverQuest 2 and gush about all my memories and nostalgia. I really appreciate it, and I hope you had some fun.